Hey, here's Jeff Rodwell.
Hi, Chuck.
Hi,
hiya,
Chuck.
Boy.
Hiya, boy.
Hi, Emma.
Hey, man. Hi, Chuck. Nice seeing you again.
Good to see you.
How you been, boy?
Fine.
Here, you take the big one.
Hey, Chuck. Ain't Emma kind of old for that long walk home?
This time she doesn't walk back. This time she rides back in style like a lady.
You want a bet?
Yeah, I'll bet
I'll take
you.
The yard.
And you.
You got yourself a bet.
And I'll take
bet.
The odds. What do you know
hey,
about
I'll
that?
I'll take a piece of that.
Don't worry
okay,
about it. Jake, how are you?
Hi,
good
Chuck.
To see you.
Good luck to you.
Thanks very much. I'll see you around, right? Don't catch cold, honey.
Oh, Chuck.
Janie, how are you, honey? What's new and exciting?
Oh, you're back.
Hi, Chuck. Back for your yearly shellacking?
Not me. Haven't you heard? This year I'm going to win. Hi, Ned.
Chuck.
Hit me.
Lady, darling, well, you already got 19. You don't say, hit me.
Well, the cards are face down. How do you know I've got 19?
How I know I don't know, but I know. Take my advice, don't take.
Hit me.
It's not the losing that bothers them. It's the pity they can't stand.
Chuck, you're big.
Answer me quick a question. How is the mama?
The mama? She's got an Italian boy haircut.
But she's not an Italian and she's not a boy. How does she look?
Honor thy father and thy mother. I'm not talking.
It's a pleasure to see you.
Prove it. Warm me up.
Can't you for once come in and not losing your shirt? Go loll a little by the pool. Go.
Deal.
No.
Deal.
No, you have to get killed. Go find a stranger.
You want me to report you to the manager?
Why not? Here I am.
Hiya, Tom.
Having trouble with the help, Chuck?
No, he's just saving me from myself.
In your case, I don't blame him. But every time the house stands to make a dime on anyone, Uncle Lonely Heart starts suffering.
Mr. Kildane. Oh, Mr. Kildane, we have a reservation, but the people in our room haven't moved out yet, and they say there are no other vacancies.
And we just got married.
Well, it won't be long. Why don't you go to the bar and have a drink on the house while you're waiting?
Well, we only got 2 days, and here's all this time being waited.
You have to tell everybody everything.
All right, Mr. Kildane. Am I fired? Yes or not?
Not. Only stop helping the customers, will you? It antagonizes them.
Well, good luck, bad luck.
Thanks, Tom. Say, honey, hold my hand a minute, will you, just for luck?
Mr. Kildane, now may I talk to you about my little girl? When you hear her,
another
you...
time, please, Gus. I was doing the Copa Room an hour ago.
Ancora.
You dance like that opening night, and I guarantee you will kill the people.
Thank you. Mr. Clodane, may I talk to you for a moment?
Oh, an hour? All day?
I don't want to be difficult, but must the waiters work during the rehearsal? It's a little distracting.
Boys, knock it off till the rehearsal is over. There now, you see how easy that was?
Thank you.
I should have thought of it myself. Some artists like to get used to the noise they'll run into during the actual performances.
Noise? What noise, Mr. Clodane?
Just the usual noise of people having dinner.
While I'm dancing, people will be eating.
Well, after all, how much noise do people make eating?
Munching celery, drinking soup, talking. Oh, no, Mr. Clodane, I'm sorry. It's impossible.
There's nothing I can do about it.
Well, you can speak to the owners, can't you?
Miss Corvier, the owners are businessmen. You say art to them, they say, art who? No, but all they know about is making money, and money they make from people. And people, while they're catching a floor show, like to eat, you see?
And what does that make me? An extra dish?
Well, honey, it makes you just about the highest priced dish in history.
C'est ça pour le moment.
Miss Corvier, artists like you with ethics and $30,000 a week for 2 weeks? You're not thinking about walking out.
I left this country when I was 13, so I can't tell you what I'm thinking. I never learned the words in English.
Maria!
Hold my hand, will you, honey, just for luck? Just a second, baby. Relax.
Seven red.
Why, you great, big, beautiful doll. That's not a hand. That's a rabbit's foot. And you're a bunny rabbit. That's what you are.
Let me go, you idiot.
Why, bunny?
Where?
That's the worst-tempered bunny I ever ran into.
Slot machine in my bedroom. People eating while I dance. And now this imbecile grabbing my hand, calling me names.
This imbecile, he was quite good looking.
What difference does that make?
To me, it would make.
What time is Pierre calling? I want to get out of this place. How could he have booked such a thing? I never heard of it.
Oh, a gift maybe from the management?
No, Mr. Rodwell. Chuck Rodwell. He says to tell you it's the rabbit's share of the profits.
What?
He says that...
Oh, don't give it back, Maria. It's money.
Oh, excuse me, ma'am. I wonder if you'd introduce me to Miss Corvier.
My dear boy, I'm afraid your timing is very wrong.
Who do you think I'm going to see? The gal with the yaller shoes. The gal with the yaller shoes and the golden hair.
Ain't nobody like her.
Fiddle up, fiddle up, fiddler man. I'm aiming to have this dance with a gal with the yaller shoes. Ain't nobody like her.
Ain't nobody like her.
Ain't nobody like the gal with the yaller shoes. Doodly-dum-bum.
Sorry, that was an accident. What I came to say is thank you for the tip, Mr. Rodwell, but I don't want it. What I do want is for you to stop bothering me. I hope I make myself entirely clear.
Look, baby.
Please stop calling me baby or honey or bunny.
I'm sorry, I don't know your name.
I don't want you to.
Okay, I don't have to. All I want to tell you is that I'm not trying to bother you. It's just that I won a lot of money when you were holding my hand.
You held my hand.
All right, I held your hand.
But you can't think that's why you won.
Well, I certainly can.
That's ridiculous.
All right, so it's ridiculous. But since I am that ridiculous, why, I thought I ought to share the winnings with you. Now, you don't have to agree with me, that's fine, but what are you so mad about? I can see you being a little annoyed, but why should you be boiling?
Not quite sure. Mr. Rodwell, I owe you an apology. I am angry, but I see now that it isn't you. I'm very sorry.
No hard feelings. Anybody I can poke in the eye for you?
I'm afraid it'd have to be my eye, so no thanks.
All of a sudden, I can't believe it. You got lucky.
Patsy, do you believe in witches?
Certainly. Why? You met one? Her? The ballerina? You're barking up the wrong witch.
Mais elle ne m'écoute pas un moment. Elle vient d'arriver. It's Pierre. I'm telling him what's what, and he's already aging 10 years.
Pierre, you know I never criticize the engagements that you make for me, but this one is a mistake.
At $30,000 a week, it can't be a mistake. Not if you want a New York opening. Darling, it's impossible for me to come out there. Just this once, you'll have to deal with the problems yourself. It isn't so difficult. It isn't as if you had to be cooperative and reasonable like a normal human being. You're a ballerina. You're not supposed to be normal.
Nobody is normal in Las Vegas. When you arrive, do they send you champagne to make you welcome? No. They send you a slot machine with the compliments of the management. They don't know you, but they talk to you. They call you honey. They call you bunny. They make jokes. I am being aloof. There's no one to be aloof from.
Maria, are you talking about people? Since when do you have anything to do with people? When you're not on the stage working, you should be in your room resting. Now remember that, and nothing will upset you. Nothing will happen to you at all. Forgive me, darling, but I'm in the middle of a costume rehearsal. I'm sorry, you'll have to stay.
Pierre says we have to stay.
Pierre says. Since you are 14, Pierre is always saying. Isn't it time you say a few words yourself?
You're the one who's always saying, listen to Pierre. A ballerina shouldn't think.
I know. It must be Las Vegas. I am reacting to it very peculiar. It's reminding me of Monte Carlo and my youth. And what a youth. But about that, you would not know, poor thing.
If you mean all those archdukes and millionaires buzzing around you like bees, I ought to know. You've told me often enough.
And from my telling, did you learn something? Here you are sitting like a wallflower. Is anyone buzzing?
I don't want anyone buzzing.
Then why do you work so hard?
Because I love to dance.
Yoy, what a reason.
Why did you work so hard when you were a ballerina?
Everything I did in my whole life, being a ballerina, marrying 3 managers in a row, everything. I had only one reason, men. I am loving men.
I can't see what's so lovable about them.
Of course not. I'm wasting my time. To a blind man, how can you talk about color? Yeah.
$15, black.
Sorry, Chuck.
Oh, honey, I enjoy this.
You sure know how to lose.
It just takes a little practice, which I've had.
Well, better luck next time.
Thanks, honey.
They paged us, but you were so busy gambling you didn't hear, and they gave the room away. So there.
Sonny, if she gets much madder, having that room won't do you any good. Oh.
Psst. Yes?
No. Just him. Just my friend, the big-time gambler. Congratulations, Speedy. I'm hearing you're losing all your money the first day this year instead of the second.
I've still got $20 and the car.
But you never sell the car till the last minute.
Just what minute do you think this is?
Why don't you stop already?
Why should I? There's nothing wrong with me that only one good hand wouldn't fix. Lotsy, did you hear what I said? I said I'm mouthful. I've been holding the wrong hands, that's all.
Come in. Come in.
Yes, Mr. Rodwell?
I was wondering, would you consider having dinner with me?
Well, thank you, but Madame Hatfany and I are having dinner here.
Hi.
Sit down. Don't be bashful. Start buzzing.
Where are you going?
When I'm coming back, I'll be making a report.
I think that she thinks you ought to go out with me. What's the point in being in Las Vegas if all you do is stay in your room?
It makes no difference where I am, Mr. Rodwell. When I'm not working, I rest. And when I'm not resting, I work.
Well, what do you do for fun? Oop.
Dancing is fun.
Oh, well, I mean, besides that.
There isn't any besides that.
Well, don't you ever feel the need for a little excitement?
Oh, I suppose everyone does from time to time.
Well, what do you do about that?
I take a cold shower. Is there anything else?
I'm not doing very well, am I?
I'm sorry. Thank you anyway.
Maybe I'd do better if I told you the truth. The fact is, I got a hunch about you. I think you're lucky for me. You see, I was losing all day long, except twice. Twice I held your hand, twice I won.
That's coincidence.
Well, what if it isn't? What if every time I hold your hand, I win? That'd be pretty interesting, wouldn't it?
Interesting. It'd be a miracle.
We'd make ourselves a fortune, too, wouldn't we? Well, that's it. Now let's go on over to the gambling casino and try it out.
Go on over to... You expect me to go trotting from table to table with you, holding your hand?
Well, when an opportunity like this comes along, you've got to take it.
What opportunity? This isn't a fact, this hunch of yours. It's a dangerous...
Just test it. It'll only take you a minute, and you won't even have to change your clothes. There's a one-arm band, a slot machine just inside the lobby. Now, all we've got to do is go over there and try it.
Well, couldn't we use the one in my bedroom?
You've got a slot machine in your bedroom?
Yes.
Oh, sister, you really raise. Come on. Entire history of Las Vegas, I think that's the first time anyone ever hit two jackpots in a row on the same machine.
It'll take me just 10 minutes to get dressed. What if the one I'm banded in my bedroom was simply out of order?
Well, we'll find out in a minute, because that's all there is to find out with.
But until you're sure, you're not going to bet at all, are you?
All isn't very much.
Yes, it is, if it's all you have. Now, in the first place, I'll add $20.
No dice. You put up the hand, I put up the money. Then we split the winnings, even Steven.
All right. But first you bet $1.
Uh-oh. I have a reputation to maintain.
A reputation for what? Winning or losing? You'll bet $1 all by yourself. If you lose, you'll bet another one, holding somebody else's hand, to see if you need me. Then I'll try. First alone, then with someone else. Because I may not need you.
Cutting me out already, huh?
Then we try together. $1 three times. If we win three times in a row, well, then, we must admit there's more to this than meets the eye.
That is quite an admission.
Chuck?
Just dollar chips.
Dollar?
Yeah, I'm teaching her the game. Let's see. First, I bet a dollar. Alone. Seven.
$17, black.
Now holding somebody else's hand.
Right.
Hold my hand, honey, will you, just for luck?
Love it.
$19, red.
Want to try again, baby? He hasn't the time. Thank you, anyway. Oh, excuse me. I didn't know you had your nurse with you.
Bunny, let me do my own brushing off, will you?
I beg your pardon. My turn. Mm-hmm.
$20, black.
Okay, grab yourself a hand.
I can't. I can't just go up to a stranger. I don't drink. Hold my hand, will you? Honey, just for luck.
For any reason you want. What's your name?
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, it's so hot and stuffy in here, I can hardly remember my own.
It's all right.
Why don't we go to the bar and talk it over? Hmm?
17 blank.
Thank you so much.
Hey, the bar's that way. The bar, you remember, where we were going to have a drink and find out who you are?
All right, Buster, take off. You had it.
Oh, I see. Sorry. I must have had her confused with someone else.
You're a pretty fast worker, Bunny.
Don't be silly. Are we ready?
All I need is the rabbit's foot. Bunny? Mm-hmm. Come on.
Black.
Two to go, right?
Right.
20. Mm-hmm.
Repeater.
Chuck, I don't think I can stand
it. Take it easy, darling. 20 again. Mm-hmm. 20.
Again.
You great, big, beautiful doll.
This is you, isn't it, Chuck?
I'm sorry. It was just that I get...
It's quite understandable.
What do you say, Chuck? You're going to try it again?
Yeah, again and again and again.
Let's go someplace and sit down.
Now?
There's so much to think about.
Like what, for heaven's sakes?
Like having dinner. I'm hungry.
Well, I guess if you're going to keep any strength in that hand, I better feed you. Cash him in, Bill. Is to move on to another club. Since you're working here at the Sands, it'd be more tactful if we broke somebody else's bank. I thought you were hungry.
I was, but now I'm not. And that's funny, because I've been hungry every day for 10 years.
That's terrible.
Suddenly, I feel there are a lot of terrible things about the way I've been living.
Well, we got to clean up as much as we can tonight. We got this fairy godmother, but who knows how long she's going to stick around.
Oh, I don't know. She picked us out, didn't she? She must have something in mind.
Yeah, well, never look a fairy godmother in the mouth, I always say. As long as we got her, let's use her. Like now. Put her out.
Chuck, could we stay and see the performance? Please? I've never been in a nightclub before.
Bunny, you baffle me. I thought all you ballerinas lived the real gay life.
Well, I've just found out we don't. That's why it's so nice just sitting here with you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Sands takes pleasure in presenting a great artist, Miss Lena Horne.
If you can dream, the world's a better place by far. If you can dream, you're anyone. Day or night, you've the right to pretend. Close your eyes, each surprise is yours, my friend. If you the love you seek is by your side. If you can dream, each kiss will leave you starry-eyed. castles and kings are everyday things. There's no extreme if you can dream. And just believe the things you dream.
We're losing money.
Could we dance? But just for a minute, I've never danced with anyone except professionally.
Honey, it occurs to me there's an awful lot of things you've never done.
You have no idea. In fact, I had no idea. And I'd like to do every single one of them tonight.
Well, we'll dance. That much I'll contribute to your education.
What kind of a combination is that? They possibly have to talk about?
Well, he's a boy and she's a girl. You'll be amazed at what a basis for conversation this can be.
Look at me dancing with a real dancer. And there's something to be said for it, too. Well, don't you like it?
It's very different from dancing on the stage. It makes me feel odd, like...
Like what?
Like having a cold shower. Let's win some money.
I thought you'd never say it.
I say, I want another man on the wheel.
Ladies and gentlemen, time out for just a minute.
Five croupiers in an hour.
What's the matter, Charlie? You're turning chicken?
Poor little fella, got a pain in your wallet.
Can't let the man get used to paying out, friends. It might get to be a habit.
Where are we going?
Same number.
Same number.
Same number.
Ten black.
Ten.
Sorry, Charlie. I thought it was the maid.
Listen, Kelly, do you know Chuck Rodwell?
Oh, yeah. He's a wonderful guy. Shame he has no luck.
You don't say. Well, that wonderful guy with the no luck is over at the tables killing me.
Chuck Rodwell? Well, that's a miracle, Charlie.
Sure, only I'm on the wrong side of the miracle, so come on.
Wait a minute. Come on where? What do you want from me?
What do you think? I want you to get him away from the table.
How?
Kelly, I'm not a girl. I don't know how girls make guys do things and stop doing things, but girls know how. And the last I heard, you were a girl.
No. No, I don't want to. I don't think it's nice.
Isn't nice?
Mm-mm.
He's already got so much, he'll have to truck it out of here. Is that nice?
Well, I don't care. I like Chuck. And I don't like you.
Well, that leaves only one question. How do you like your job?
Let's stop for a while, huh?
What for?
Yeah, for what?
What's up? He can't quit now.
I'm sorry. I thought it'd be fun to have a little fun. You know, talk, dance, or talk.
We can do that any old time.
Chuck!
Kelly!
You've been here all day and didn't look me up, huh? It's just to show you what you missed.
Since when do you worry about what I miss?
Since I found out you're making a fortune. You've always been a little doll. With a little money, you'll be a big doll.
Is that enough?
Oh, Chuck. To put it simply, I'm mad about you. Besides, I want to learn your system.
You can meet my system.
Huh?
Maria, this is Kelly Donovan, an old friend of mine. It's Maria Corvier.
Hi. Ballerina?
Mm-hmm.
Well, aren't you stepping into the big time, boy?
Dancing girls on both sides. This is a dream I have quite often.
Well, look, beautiful dreamer. Now that you're loaded, I hope you realize I'm not going to let you out of my sight.
Isn't she wonderful?
Isn't she? Look, sweetie, I have to give what my agent laughingly calls a performance. So why don't you two drop over to the Silver Slipper and lead the applause? And if you bring your money with you, I may sit at your table afterwards.
Promise?
Mm-hmm.
We'll cash in our chips and we'll be there.
Chuck, you promised me?
Mm-hmm. Anyway, Maria wanted to quit, didn't you?
But you didn't.
Yeah, but now I do. Besides, we're off to a pretty good start, so it'll just work out fine.
I couldn't have planned it better. Oh, come on, honey. If you're a good girl, I may tell you all about him.
You're looking at a real sophisticate. The lust for life has been my goal. I've done a lot of things I shan't relate, but I refuse to rock and roll. I've been the inspiration for a song with spicy lyrics by Dear Cole. And I've been banned in Boston right along, but I refuse to rock and roll. It's not that it takes emotions that I lack. I've got what you might call respect for my sacroiliac. I've danced with sailors at the USO, for which I got a Navy scroll. And I've been tattooed where it doesn't show, but I refuse to rock and roll. I've been to dinner with that ex-king man. He offered me a pink mink stole. The gifts he promised me could fill a van, but I refuse to rock and roll. That prince used to court me everywhere I went. I wince when I think of the times that he chased me round the tent. I have a lot of virtues, I suppose, but none a spinster would extol. The point is, I'm not the purest rose, but I refuse to give in to rhythm and blues. To save my soul, I just won't rock. To save my soul, I refuse to rock and roll.
Isn't she sensational? Isn't she just about the cutest thing you've ever seen?
No. No, I don't think she's the cutest thing I've ever seen. Well, you asked me.
Funny. Could you be getting a little loaded?
Hmm?
You know, tight, drunk.
Oh, no, I don't think so. I'm lucky. But not that
lucky. Hi, honey. Kelly, it was just great.
Don't strain, boy. You're rich. What did you think? I think you're the cutest thing Chuck has ever seen. Well, how nice of you to tell me. Say, I'm through for the night. Why don't we all go someplace?
We're all yours.
I'm not.
I'm not yours at all, at all.
Well, you know what I think? I think you're having a tantrum.
Oh, no, she's not.
Yes, I am, and I have to be given my own way. Right back to the roulette wheel.
No, you don't want to do that.
Don't we? What if this isn't available tomorrow?
Honey, she's got a point.
Well, she's missing a better point. Just take a look at what's coming on.
This is bigger than both of us.
More than gambling, more than me. That's what he loves.
My lucky charm. Just wait until you look her over. My lucky charm. It's worth her weight in a four-leaf clover. If you're wondering lately why I've been doing greatly, I must insist it's 'cause I've kissed. My lucky charm is not a trinket that I carry. My lucky charm is someone I intend to marry. If you want to see her, from now on you can see her on my arm. The lovely lady I call my lucky charm.
Just wanted to know how you feel about ballet.
What?
Ballet.
Oh, ballet. Oh, I can take it or leave it. Of course, I haven't seen you yet.
You certainly haven't. He certainly hasn't, has he? Hmm? Oh, I don't know, honey. You lost me quite a way back. No, I didn't. I hoped to, but I didn't. That's what I'm working on now.
It's possible. I've kissed my lucky charm. It's not a trinket that I carry. My lucky charm is someone I intend to marry. If you want to see him, from now on you can see him on your own. The daddy, I call my lucky charm.
Ashamed of yourself. What were you thinking of, you and Pierre, to let me live this long and be this ignorant?
Ignorant about what?
About men. Half the human race, that's all.
Maria, darling, begin from the beginning. What happened?
Nothing happened. I'm a failure. I'm worse than a failure. I'm invisible. A man can sit with me, dance with me, talk with me.
even kiss me. Not even see me.
He talked to you, danced with you, kissed you, and you say nothing happened?
Yeah. Nothing happened. It's my hand he's interested in, not me. Shame it isn't detachable. A little snip comes along who walks like this. And he goes. 10 elephants come along who dance like that. And he goes. Ah, 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 ah. And when I do the very same thing, he doesn't even see me.
So, you like him?
Like him? Yes, I like him. Not that there's anything so remarkable about it.
With all the millions of men in the world, how can anyone be so remarkable?
Not that I would have chosen to like it. Yes, I like him.
So he's calling. What could be more convenient?
Don't answer it. I have nothing to say to him.
But you just said you liked him.
To like a man who can't even see you isn't sensible. To like a man who can't even see you doesn't mean you can't hate him.
Hello. No, here is not Bunny. She's here, Bunny, but she, her, here, this is not her. You are following. She's not wanting to talk to you. Look, darling, me you do not have to convince. I'm talking to you. She's not. Wait a minute. I'll see what's what. Eoy. My boy, she's taking a cold shower. What this means, I cannot begin to tell you. But for you, it is not good.
Chuck! Chuck! I'm hearing you and the ballerina, you are cleaning up like two brooms.
Yeah.
Oh, you are so used to it. You are bored already?
She's so mad at me, she won't even talk to me on the telephone. I don't know what I did to hurt her feelings. I got problems.
Now, this everyone has, but besides problems, you got money and this you never have. Let me see it. Let me feast my eyes.
Oh, Lotsy, it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Let me look. It wouldn't tire me.
Oh. Half of this is hers. Oh. You know something, Lotsy? She's an awfully nice girl.
The dope and his money are soon parted. I'm keeping this until tomorrow.
Look, I'm not going to gamble any more tonight. I can't without her. Now, come on, I want to go to bed.
Look, I'm making a deal. May my boss, Mr. Couldain, drop dead if I'm not giving you the money tomorrow.
Okay, Lacio, you win. I'll see you in the morning.
High-flying ballerino stops the show at Silver Slipper. People eating while you're dancing, that disturbs you. Doing publicity pictures by the pool, that was vulgar. But getting crocked in a saloon and going like this, oh, that's art, that's high class, that's just dandy.
I've told you, I'm sorry.
What do you want her to do to prove it? Push a peanut with her nose from Las Vegas to New York?
If it would get her out of my sight, why not? When I think what I've done to keep you happy, that ridiculous salary, your own personal slot machine, giving in to you right and left and right,
Calder,
right?
Will you please get in touch with my manager?
Oh, I got in touch with your manager before the sun was up. And you know what he had the gall to claim? He said that what you did had no effect whatsoever on your contract. Is that one for the book?
I don't care what he said. We're leaving on the next plane.
That's perfectly all right.
It is here, Madame Hatvani.
I'll get the plane.
It is here, Tom Caldein also. And you are welcome to him, you are sure?
Yes, yes, what is it? They are? How many? That many. Yes, yes, I see. Well, you tell them I'll be right over. Oh, what a beautiful morning. 7 owners of the Sands are here. 2 more than have ever been together at one time. And they want to see me. Guess why? Therefore, these are my parting words. Get packed!
Oh.
Mr. Cardin.
Gus, I know you love your little girl, but man, there's a time and a place.
I just wanted to tell you the owners are waiting.
Oh, thank you. You're very kind. Good morning, gentlemen. I think I know what you're going to say.
Tommy, here's our genius with a giant brain.
How do you like that? I was going to fire up for hiring the ballerina.
We ought to get down on our knees and apologize.
You'd rather have a bonus, wouldn't you, Tom?
Look at him at 9 o'clock in the morning.
It's better than the hottest Saturday night we ever had.
Wherever that ballerina is, that's where they want to be. Well, the girl having luck was an accident. But to publicize it by arranging the silver slipper caper, that was pure genius.
How did you think of it, Tom? Well, you know there's more to my job than just seeing that the waiters have clean shirts.
Good morning, friends.
Some of the boys wanted me to have a little chat with you.
So chat.
Thanks to Mr. Slob Caldane, an employee of the Sands became a public benefactor last night at every place but the Sands. We took quite a shellacking. But I'm not here to complain. I'm here to discuss a matter of principle. The principle of gambling, which is based on the element of chance, right? But when that ballerina of yours comes to the table, there isn't any element of chance, right? So it isn't gambling, right?
So get out an injunction.
We got a better idea. Get rid of her. Send her to Mexico. Send her to Reno. Let her break their banks, but get her out of Vegas.
Tom, we've got the little lady for 2 weeks, haven't we, with an option for a third? Well, you trot up and see her right now. Tell her we love her, and we hereby exercise our option for the third week.
And just as many more as we can get.
I'm on my way.
And remember, Tom, we're holding you personally responsible for the little girl's happiness every minute she's in Las Vegas. Well, you know,
Chuck, haven't you got a heart? It might mean my bonus.
You won't stay here. Even my job. It's such a little thing for me to ask you, and such a little thing for you to ask her.
Tom, I am not going to ask her anything. If she wants to quit, that's her business. Between the papers and the way you acted, I do not blame her.
Chuck. Oh, buddy. 3 years ago, when you went broke, who bought your car and paid the list price?
Tom, you're wasting your time.
And 2 years ago, when you were hocked up to your eyeballs, those out-of-town jarpies, who squared it? And then
Tom, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I am going to go and get the money from Lotsie. Then I'm going to try and see Maria and give her her hat. And then I'm going to thank her for winning me my hat. And then I'm going to apologize for getting her into this mess. And then I'm going to say goodbye.
I'm going to marry her, so whether you like it or
not.
Be quiet, Mr. Caldane. You talk too much. The only thing that could possibly keep me from opening here would be my deciding not to. Not your deciding anything. If I made a fool of myself last night, why shouldn't I? If I want to can-can down Main Street, or gamble with him, or not gamble with him, why shouldn't I? Let's get this straight, Mr. Caldane. What I do or I don't do depends entirely on me.
Man, that's no bunny. That's a tiger.
Well, whatever she is, she can have me. Well, I think I'll go in and pick up my bonus. Gus! Gus, I hear your little girl just loaded with talent. Why didn't you tell me, man? It's my department. I'll audition her right after the ballet rehearsal, all right?
Mr. Caldane, you sure you didn't get fired?
Fired?
Well, everything's lucky, Chucky.
And a happy good morning to you.
You're having a fine night's sleep, I hope.
Wonderful. I spent the night with Emma.
Don't worry, girls. It's a horse, Emma.
Now that you've got my good name cleared up, may I have the money, if you please?
What money?
Wait, now, quit kidding. I'm in a hurry.
Who's kidding? And also, who's got the money?
What do you mean, who's got the money?
I mean, it's gone, my boy. By special messenger, straight to your mama.
You told me you'd give it back to me the minute I asked for it. You promised.
Who believes a Hungarian promise? Just to show you I'm a sport. Here, mine boy.
Mine boy, I'll get back to you later in spades. What are you doing here?
Looking for you.
Funny place to be looking for me.
Why? I found you, didn't I?
Let's all be on stage and ready for rehearsal at 6 o'clock.
That was the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Thought you didn't care about ballet.
That's what I thought, too. But I was wrong.
I suppose you want to gamble.
Oh, if you'd like to and you're not busy.
I am busy. I'm very busy. If it's convenient later on, which I rather doubt, I'll get in touch with you.
I'll pick you up right here in 15 minutes.
Well, so long, old horse. It's been real nice knowing you.
Where are you going?
I've just decided I've been outclassed. I can't take the competition.
I didn't know there was any.
You think we tell you guys everything?
Okay, fellas. The curtain. Bring out those screens. All right, Gus, bring on your little doll.
Well, what do you know? She really is a doll.
上手に歌うなよ, ね? 落ち着いてね? 上手に歌うなよ, ね? はい!
赤い生いた紫リボン歌うことりよ気な娘可愛い流し目で街から街を飛び回るエクボ見せて歩く姿すてきでしょどなたも一目でささやきかけるああ一人ぼっち 散歩しましょう、センチはいやよ。
Well, she's awfully cute, Gus, but she can't speak English, and I don't know...
She can't speak it, but she can sing it. Listen, Mitsuko, 今度英語の歌を歌うのね。ラッキーチャーム歌うのね。
Yes, I'm just a quarter.
She said you scare her.
That's ridiculous. I love little kitties.
そんなこと言わないでね、歌うのね。 She'll sing. She'll sing. You know Lucky Charm?
Sure, Lucky Charm, boys.
Hold it, Huffy. Pete. Just a second, huh? Pete, would you mind playing piano?
Me too. Here.
And, Pete, just kind of slow and easy, okay? Huh? Okay. Now, you sit right up here. Now, you sing with me, huh? Just watch me, okay?
My lucky charm. Wait until you look her over. My lucky charm. Worth a wait in four-leaf clover. If you're wondering lately why I've been doing lately,
I must insist.
It's cause
I've kissed
my lucky charm. Is not a trinket that I carry.
My lucky charm
is someone I intend to marry. If you want to see her, from now on you can see her. Oh, my, the lovely lady I call my lucky charm. Baba, diddy, do 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 do
do do do do do do do do do
do do do
do do do do do
do do do do do do
do do do do
do do do do
do do do do do do do do do
do do do
do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do.
My lucky charm is not a trinket
that
I carry. My lucky charm
is someone I
intend to marry. If you wanna see her, from now on you can see her. My arm.
The lovely lady.
I call my lucky.
Charm.
The lovely lady. I call my lucky charm. The lovely lady. I call my lucky
I think we can use her.
You know something? You look positively beautiful.
I look exactly the way I looked last night.
Well, then you must have looked beautiful last night, too.
Hi, you two. Well, what's it going to be, blackjack or roulette? We fixed up a private little room so you can gamble all by yourselves without anyone annoying you.
And without anyone betting along with us.
What are you, philanthropists? You have to win for everyone? Come on, I'll show you.
When we want to gamble, we'll tell you. It isn't compulsory, is it?
Anytime you need me, Miss Corvier, I'm yours. Nothing like winning a couple of bucks for turning a nice guy into a crank.
Why should he take it for granted that we want to gamble every minute?
Well, why shouldn't he? You're a gambler, aren't you? At least you're always gambling.
Well, sure, I'm in Las Vegas. And if I were in a swimming pool, I'd be swimming. But that doesn't mean I'd make swimming my life's work, does it?
Well, no. The truth is, I don't know anything about you, do I? Except that when we hold hands, something happens.
Well, that's a pretty good place to start from, isn't it? If you'd like to know any more, it can be arranged.
All right. Arrange it. With that name, this must have something to do with you.
Well, on all my bank loans, it says rancher.
I wondered last night when I was thinking about you, how you managed to stay so healthy looking, spending all your time in gambling rooms.
I was thinking about you last night, too.
You're so big. You must be very rich.
Well, I own a lot, but what I own doesn't usually include money.
Chuck, aren't you any good at ranching?
Well, I have a diploma from an agricultural college that says I am.
Then why don't you make money at it?
I do.
But if you make it, then why don't you have it?
I lose it. Oh, not all of it, just the profits. The profits I take to Las Vegas.
You mean you gamble it away? But why?
I like gambling. You liked gambling last night, too, didn't you?
Well, yes, but we were winning. You're always losing.
Well, Bunny, if you like gambling, that includes winning and losing. It's hard to explain.
It must be. It doesn't make sense.
No, that's right, it doesn't. You know, cards, roulette, and dice, they don't care whether you're a nice guy or a louse, whether you're a scientific player with a system or just a superstitious bum like me. And that's what I like about it. There are no rules. And there are so many rules about everything. You know, if you work hard, you make money. You don't work hard, you go broke. You plant alfalfa, you get alfalfa.
What's wrong with that?
Well, it leaves out all the surprises, like you. Now, where does a rancher-type guy like me meet up with a ballerina like you? Now that's like planting alfalfa and getting violets.
So quiet, so peaceful after Las Vegas. No people. No people. Aren't there any people here at all?
It's a house rule. Nobody works while the boss is away. They wouldn't anyway, so why should I make them feel guilty? Buddy, these are my so-called helpers. This is Scotty, Joe, Pete, Whitey, Buck, Horrible, Slim, and Lee, our chef.
Hi.
Fellas, this is Maria Corgi.
Is she the one with a hand?
Yeah, she's the one with... What are you guys, got a pipeline to Vegas?
I'll take on anyone at any time on anything.
If you'll pardon the expression, what's cooking?
Half a beef in the barbecue pit.
Company?
She played bingo at the church last night and won 70 cents. She got so carried away... She invited the whole congregation for dinner.
How is she?
Cranky.
Where is she?
In the hen house, telling off the hens.
Well, who is she?
She is Miss Hattie, my old lady, a very disagreeable type.
You mean you're talking about your mother?
Yes, but don't say it in such reverent tones. She ain't Whistler's mother, she's mine. You'll see for yourself, we'll go call her. Whitey, take care of the car.
I hope sure, I boss. See you again.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
I hope so,
boy,
ma'am.
Oh, Bunny. One thing, if my mother gets fresh, just talk back.
You think she won't like me?
Oh, it isn't that. She just doesn't like girls. At least she hasn't up to now.
I suppose there have been a great many. Girls, I mean. What is it she doesn't like about them?
Well, she has no use for what she calls modern youth.
Too wild for her?
Oh, no. Too tame.
Oh.
And you call yourself a hen. You can do it if you put your ever-loving mind to it, you foul, foul.
You haven't been able to bully Teresa into laying an egg for the last 3 years. You're not going to start now.
Another one?
Behave yourself. This is Maria Corvia. I'm not broke. You can thank her.
I heard. The girl with the golden mitt.
Yeah.
How do you do, Mrs. Rodwell?
Howdy.
She learned that in the movies.
I'm glad to know you. The dancy girl, huh? He always goes for him, just like his dad.
Just like his paw, you mean. Stay in character.
I stand corrected.
How often do you take them out for a walk?
We don't. Their feet never touch the ground.
Never in their whole lives? The poor things.
What a rancher's wife you'd make. Come on, we'll give you the guided tour.
When you've seen Teresa, you've seen our worst.
Don't let it get you, Ma. Don't give her the satisfaction. Daisy, Slim. Is she gonna have a calf?
No, the vet looked her over this morning. Said she dreamed the whole thing up.
Never saw such a notional cow. Remember when I delivered her last one? Even after it was born, she wouldn't believe it.
You mean yourself?
Yes. When you live in a place like this, you develop some mighty odd talents.
What a rancher's wife I'd make is right. When my cat had kittens, I fainted.
Daisy's gonna be a mom!
Yippee!
Daisy's gonna be a mom!
It's a girl! It's a girl!
Who?
Daisy.
Daisy?
Daisy!
What's that hole in the ground over there?
Just what you said, a hole in the ground. But with that pile we're going to make in Las Vegas tonight, I think I can make it even a bigger hole in the ground. With maybe a little oil at the bottom. You know, I think we can get down another 100 feet or so with just that money that Lotsie sent you.
The money Lotsie sent who?
Didn't you get a wad of money from Las Vegas this morning?
I didn't get anything from any place this morning.
Why, the dirty, double-dealing Hungarian dealer. Bunny, wait a minute, be careful.
Listen, what was that about the money we're going to make in Las Vegas? You don't actually believe all that dribble about holding hands, do you?
Oh, it's true, Mrs. Rodwell. We don't know what it is, but it works every time.
Well, anyone can tell Chuck has no brains, but for a sensible girl like you.
Oh! Oil! Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
What a wife she'd make for a rancher.
Mother, I've told you I've known her 24 hours. That's only one day.
Yes, and in that day, the hens have laid a year's supply of eggs. A cow with an ailment diagnoses indigestion has had a calf, not to say anything about a well without a pump that's hollered, dig me, I've got oil. Oh, don't bicker, son. The evidence is piling up. Well, what are you going to do about her?
Do I usually do anything about a girl I've known 24 hours?
Yep.
Well, maybe, but Bunny's different. She's kind of special. Anyway, it's ridiculous to talk about it. You see, she's an artist, and she's got a certain kind of a future.
Yes, and she's got a hand that'll do her absolutely no good without your hand holding it.
Do you think that if we really liked each other, it would matter to me whether we had the luck or not?
I don't know, Chuck. I just got sort of fascinated with the idea that if you did like each other, you'd have the luck, too.
Well, that's pretty mercenary, isn't it?
I don't know.
Well, anyway, I'm going to take her back to Las Vegas before I get any fancy ideas.
Now, it seems to me you could stay for dinner. What fancy ideas can you get while you're eating?
Well, it'd be different if it wasn't a barbecue. But, you know, you get out there with the fire and the guitars and the moonlight and the stars and, you know me. Mm-hmm. No, I am taking her back to Las Vegas. Honey, do you think you could possibly stay for dinner?
Oh, yes. I call Sherry and cancel the rehearsal.
Say, that's a pretty good fit, huh?
I may never take it off.
I thought she was built like Grandma the minute I saw her. She was a big gal, too.
Mother.
Hmm?
Bunny's gonna stay for dinner.
Good. In that case, I'm glad it's a barbecue.
Aren't you hungry, Chuck?
No. That's funny, because I'm always hungry.
There must be some explanation.
You ever get fat?
Not so far.
I don't think you ever will. Grandma never did.
It isn't every day that a man meets a girl who reminds his own mother of his own grandmother.
Hey, boss, let's get set up.
I'll be right there.
Excuse me. I hear that in your own line you're pretty important.
Promising, the critics say, that's all.
Ever think of giving it up?
No.
Good for you. I never could stand the kind of woman that hankered to be a housewife. You like my boy?
Yes.
Got any plans for him?
Well, I haven't wanted to think too much about it.
Why not? What are you scared of?
We probably haven't too much in common.
Well, I don't know. If you live in the same house with a man long enough, have a few quarrels and a few worries, not to mention anything else that might come along. Get sunburned with him in the summer and have the flu with him in the winter. You're bound to end up having something in common.
Miss Hattie, I thought you didn't like girls.
It's been 20 years since I've seen a girl who eats like you. I'm telling you, it's a pleasure.
I'm going to see the gal with the yaller shoes. The gal with the yaller shoes and the golden hair.
Ain't nobody like her. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, horse.
You know that I want to be
with a gal with the yaller shoes. Ain't nobody like her.
Who's got a smile that spells romance?
The gal with the yaller shoes. The gal with the yaller shoes and the golden hair.
Ain't nobody like her.
Fiddle up, fiddle up, fiddler man.
I'm aiming to have this dance
with a gal with the yaller shoes. Oh, you can take all the others and give them to the seven brothers.
As for me, the only bride I'll choose is not the gal in calico. I just pass her by, I know. For the
gal with the yaller ain't no gal that's swaller than the gal with the yaller shoes.
Ain't nobody like her.
Ain't nobody like her. Ain't nobody like her. Ain't nobody like the gal with the yaller shoes.
Parading in the sands in that outfit.
It looks just beautiful.
My mother will send your clothes on to you.
Oh, no, I won't. If she wants them, she can come and get them.
It's the nicest time I've had in my whole life.
And there's plenty more where it came from.
What? Well, what?
Oh, never mind. If I tell you what to do, you won't, so I won't. Oh, goodness. Bye.
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 Lucky you are living here.
You really like it, don't you?
I really love it.
No ballet on the ranch.
No barbecue in the theater.
You know, the great way to live would be 6 months on the ranch and 6 months wherever the ballet is.
That would be a great way to live.
Bunny, are you just talking or do you know what you're saying?
I know what I'm saying. I just don't know where it's going.
I do. Let's get married right away. Well, that's what you had in mind, isn't it?
No, I just had in mind that I love you. I thought that was enough for now.
Well, that's not enough for me. Because I love you, too. I'm old-fashioned.
Oh, Sherry, have I got things to tell you?
Yes, you're right, it's me. But why do you look so horrified? Yesterday on the telephone, you begged me to come.
Well, I'm surprised, that's all, since you told me you couldn't come.
Well, as a ballerina, you didn't need me. But as a burlesque queen and a gambler small, I thought you might. Yes, I know everything.
No. No one knows everything except me. And I may or I may not tell you.
Ah, Maria, why are you trying to fight with me? I didn't come to scold. If you made a little gossip, it turns out it's good for business. And if you met a nice young man and amused yourself, why should it bother me?
That's right. It shouldn't, should it?
And it doesn't, darling.
I'm so glad you said that. It may sound silly, but I've been so worried how to tell you.
How to tell me what, my big baby?
That I'm going to marry Chuck.
You're going to what?
Well,
No. Don't say it again. You chaperone!
Who said marry? All I wanted was she should fall in love a little.
You can't fall in love a little. You either do or you don't, and I did, and it's wonderful.
With that cowboy?
With that cowboy.
Oh. Till now, I didn't know cowboy was a dirty word.
We're going to spend 6 months a year on the ranch and 6 months with the ballet, and we're going to be perfectly happy. It's his grandmother's, and I love it. I know everything you're going to say, so don't. Yes, I've known him only one day. That's all it took. No, we don't seem to have anything in common. Well, what we have in common is none of your business. No, it doesn't seem to make sense, but we don't have to make sense. Because if we can make a fortune every time we hold hands, who needs to make sense?
You mean it's true about the luck?
Well, yes, it's true, but it doesn't matter. What does matter is that Chuck and I are going out to celebrate, and you're not going to say a single word about it.
Not even a little word, like congratulations?
Do you mean it? Shari, does he mean it?
Well, in my long and enjoyable life, I know plenty managers. But when the ballerina comes and says she's going to marry, each and everyone except him has at the very least a heart attack.
Ah, but they were art lovers. I'm a businessman. And if two people can't lose together, it is obvious to any businessman that they belong together.
Oh, Pierre, you do mean it. Wait till you meet him. He'll be here in a minute. Well, I've got to change.
May I join the celebration? I'll take the check and leave with the check. Of course, after drinking your health in champagne. If they have champagne in Las Vegas.
They have everything in Las Vegas.
Chuck! Doll baby!
Yes, it's doll baby. And nobody sent doll baby's mama nothing. No money, not even an old postcard.
Chuck, if you're killing me here, people will talk.
There's only one thing I have to say to you. Take good care of that money.
You're not wanting it for gambling?
Gambling? Ooh, I'll go.
Hit me, you creep.
So I'm coming.
Did she tell you, Sherry? Well, what do I get? Kiss or a freeze? I knew you'd be for it.
Oh, Chuck, this is Maria's manager, Pierre Duval. This is the cowboy, him.
I thought you were in New York, but I'm not. I know how you must feel about all this, and I know exactly what you're going to say.
Everybody knows exactly what I'm going to say.
Don't say it for him, darling. He's on our side.
Buddy, I don't know if I can stand the way you look. Let me get this straight. You mean you're not against us?
Well, I'm a hard man with a dollar, but I'm going to buy you champagne tonight. That should prove something.
He's a good guy, Bonnie.
One has to know him a little better to appreciate him.
Don't mind, Jerry. Once a ballerina, always a manager hater.
Not me. Not tonight. But isn't it time we started celebrating?
I haven't stopped celebrating since we left the ranch. The ranch gate, to be exact.
These are the magic hands. I'm dying to see them in action. Can we on our way, please?
Oh, no, not tonight. We don't want to gamble tonight, do we, Jerry?
Oh, just one turn of the wheel for a man who is on your side.
Let's make him a little money. It'll only take a minute.
It's such a nice way to start an evening, or end an evening, or even spend an evening.
Three, red.
Hey, here they come. Excuse us, please. Thank you. Hi. Hey, we were getting calluses waiting for you.
Hello, Jeff.
Don't worry, Bill. We're just going to make one bet.
I'm begging your pardon. Mogo moy dihal.
Igen.
How sweet it is.
Put some more chips on.
17.
He's on 17.
Sweet it is.
You're on.
Ten, black.
Oh, no, we bet.
Ten?
No.
Here, Chuck. Here's some more money.
No. You see, it has to be ours. That's what's wrong. We have to bet with our own money.
He's wanting his money. I'm having it.
Don't give him it.
Our natte is bigger.
I'll be right.
Quick. With the ballerina, you will find me, Madame Hatvani. Oh. My name is...
It's a pleasure to meet you. Goodbye. Harry, beat it. Kill me, you wouldn't get more. It's buried the rest.
It's gonna be it. 17 again.
17.
Yes, you're on 17, lady. Seven.
No.
Red.
No.
This is it.
Red.
To our fairy godmother.
She took a powder, that's all. Well, she got us together. I guess she figured that's all she was supposed to do. We'll show her. We won't invite her to our party, right?
Right.
Right. I'm glad you're taking it this way.
Well, why should we take it any other way? Doesn't make any difference to us, does it, Bunny?
No, darling. Only please don't call me Bunny anymore.
Sorry your luck ran out. That's the way it goes. You win till you lose, then you lose.
With that happy thought, here we are.
Just some wine, the Lanson 47. You may clear this away.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Sands presents for your pleasure...
Ladies and gentlemen, the management of the Sands Hotel, whose policy is drag them in, never mind how, has asked me to throw a little bait your way in the shape, and I say the very gorgeous shape, of the star of our next show. The very beautiful ballerina, Maria Corbier. Miss Corbier!
Watch her face. Never saw a ballerina yet who didn't live on applause.
Dull business things to discuss, but I'll be very understanding if you'd like to be alone.
Oh, well, it's been a long day, and I imagine you're a little tired, aren't you?
A little. You look tired, too.
Yeah. Night, dear.
Good night, darling.
See you in the morning.
Let's not talk about business or anything tonight. I'm tired.
Of course you are, my dear. You've been on a big gay merry-go-round. You have to expect a little letdown when the music stops. And it always does. On merry-go-rounds.
Good night.
Good night.
Pierre, what happened?
They lost.
Your money, I know. I was peeking. But after what happened?
They lost.
But they had no more money to lose.
Whatever they had, they lost.
What's giving him that type expression on the face?
Oh, that's love, Lotsy. Love turned a little sour. You know, I think I'll start warming up. I have a hunch I'll be off the bench any minute. Hit me.
That's fitting in exactly with my plans. Go home, wash out your mouth with soap. To an individual, what is looking happy when another individual is looking unhappy, I'm not dealing.
Did you told her?
Nice girl, but no heart. In my opinion, no woman has heart until she's reaching, say, 45.
Say, 49. Give a little, take a little. I'm bringing back the money, but I give you only his half. The way things are with them, hers I'll give her myself.
The way things are with them?
Terrible. Soon to be worse, terrible.
You were enjoying maybe a little blackjack?
To play cards with a man, to me it's a waste. If you are suggesting, for example, a little walk by the pool.
Madame Hatvani, be my guest.
Buy you a drink?
Oh, no, thanks. I have one. Besides, I cost you enough tonight.
forget it. I'm just sorry for your sake. Scotch and water, please.
How's Maria?
A little depressed, like you. To be sure you can't lose and to find you can, it's enough to depress anybody.
It wasn't the money. It was the magic. It really was like a fairy tale, you know. We were under a spell and nothing mattered that really matters. Then the wheel turned to the wrong number. The spell was broken.
Back to the cold, cold world where everything matters.
It just takes a little getting used to, that's all. It doesn't change anything. We weren't so completely moonstruck that we didn't make a few sensible plans.
I know. 6 months here, 6 months there.
Pierre, you've known Maria a long time, haven't you? And you probably have given quite a bit of thought to us. And tell me, do you think it'll work?
No. No, I don't think it'll work. And neither do you, or you wouldn't have asked me.
No, that's not true. I just want to make sure that Maria's happy out on the ranch.
going barefoot, milking cows, picking eggs? She might be. But that still leaves the other 6 months when she's working. Will you be happy doing what?
Well, I haven't given that much thought.
You've given it lots of thought, Chuck. You just haven't come up with any answer.
You mind if I keep trying?
Not at all. Try all you want and good luck to you. But do me a favor, Chuck, will you please? Keep away from Maria tomorrow. She has to work and she won't be able to if you're around. They're nervous creatures, ballerinas. You might as well get used to it.
I imagine you'll take a little getting used to, too.
Oh, I won't give you any trouble. I'm a realist. Whatever Maria decides, I'll be for it.
Well, that makes my evening.
Good night.
Good night.
Maria.
Good morning, darling.
Good morning.
Going to watch the rehearsal?
Oh, no. I knew you'd be busy today, so I thought I'd go on out to the ranch.
There's nothing wrong, is there?
At the ranch? Oh, no, no, no. It's just that there's a few things I ought to look after.
I'll miss you.
I'll miss you, too.
Chuck. It isn't going to work, is it?
No, darling, it isn't going to work. But it was wonderful, and I'll never forget it.
I'll never forget you. Goodbye, darling.
Bob, I didn't know I was coming.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Sands proudly presents Maria Corvier in Frankie and Johnny, narrated by the voice of Sammy Davis Jr.
Frankie and Johnny were lovers. Man, how those two cats could love. They promised to dig one another long as stars remained above. He was her mate, but he wouldn't fly straight. He was a cat that was lazy. Thinking of work made him frown. Man, she had a bank that was crazy, and his loans were not turned down. She was his fool. Daddy-o, he played it real cool. What a drag. They sashayed down to the barroom, a place where you go chaperone. Strictly a come as you are, and the clientele was stone. Everyone was juiced, as you may have deduced. Was sultry and torrid, and Frankie was limp from the heat. She planted a kiss on his forehead, and then she beat a quick retreat. For as you might suppose, She had to powder her nose. Now enter a doll named Nelly, a weirdie the hipsters would boast. Man, Poe is like Byron or Shelley, would have dubbed this chick the most. Jack, this gal came on sort of like a female Don Juan. Ladies. You never saw such a tango. That Frankie sure fought for a gent. She threw punches from every angle. Man, it looked like the main event. Someone rang a bell, but Daddy Odie couldn't save Nell. He had whipped out a pistol, and everyone made for the door. She started busting the crystal, and she made that cannon roar. Missed. When she fired that last shot, did Johnny hear? He did not. She was such a lady. Man, how that Frankie did suffer.
She's going to dance again.
She'll be wonderful again.
Listen to that. That's what you're going to have every night. Not just every now and then.
Well, so long, Lucy. See you next year.
You're going? It's finished? Love comes along every day so you can say fooey to it?
I'm not saying fooey to anything. I'm just trying to be sensible, that's all.
Take your money and goodbye. I'm washing my hands.
You're the one that's always trying to get me to be sensible.
So I'm not liking you to be sensible. Do me something.
Haven't any luck?
You'd have to be very greedy to want any more luck than this.
If you can dream, the world's a better place by far.
I wonder what happened.
I must have said something wrong.
Every day of your darling little life, you should say such darling wrong things.
I'm almost ready.
Excuse me. Supposed to be at the ranch.
But I'm not.
Close your eyes. Each surprise is yours, my friend.
You watch where you're going.
I did, Cher Pierre.
Cher Pierre.
What's going on in there?
What a stupid question. I wouldn't do it.
6 months here.
And 6 months there.
And no more gap.
No more gap.
Don't you understand? Lucky at love, unlucky at cards. Or versa vice.
Versa vice.
If you can dream and just believe the thing.